What is up, my fellow mobile gamers? In today's video, we are taking a look at the best build for the Berserker. Before we get started, I'm gonna ask that you hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the notification bell, comment down below. What are you asking Santa for Christmas? If you had one wish, what would you wish for? All right, so this build right here that we have that we're about to show off is a very powerful build. When we played in the Korean server, for those who don't know, I actually played the Korean version way before the game went global. Now, the problem with this build that I'm going to show off is this build was more kind of late game, I should say. A lot of the skills that we're going to be using are a lot of the red skills. Before in my wizard video and my assassin video, what I usually like to do is do an early build where I go use these first couple ones, and then I'll go and I'll say, okay, do I like the upgraded version over the regular version, which is the yellow or the red? Apparently people didn't like that when I did that. People were just leaving nasty comments and stuff. I'm just, giving suggestions. That's all I'm doing, is just giving suggestions. If you don't like my build, you don't have to go with my build. Okay? I don't know why people get so upset about this stuff. It's literally just one person's opinion, and I'm just trying to help you guys out and give some suggestions. When you enhance them, there are some that you're going to want to enhance more than others. We'll go over that first real quick. Hidden Anger. This one we are going to use in both our PvE build, when we're going out farming monsters, and when we are doing PvP. So Hidden Anger right here is used in PvE and PvP builds. I'm going to give you two builds. So this one is a must. You can level this one up. And this is one of the first abilities that you start off with early on. So you can level this one up no problem, as much as you want. Another one that we're going to be using, and you get this skill early on, is Sweep. This one is also very important. This is one of our best skills as a Berserker. I highly suggest you invest in this as much as you can. This is very important, just because it has a super low cooldown, and this just helps so much with farming big mobs and just taking out lots of enemies. This is one of our best abilities, Sweep. We keep this the entire game. So from the beginning, from the start to the end game, Sweep we will use, Hidden Anger we will use. These two are super important. Another one that we are going to use, Beatdown is also another one that we get early on, and we're going to be using endgame too. So Beatdown is another one that you're going to want to invest in. Very good. Damage, decrease enemy accuracy. So Beatdown, Hidden Anger, and Sweep. These three we are going to keep with us to the end game. Now, the other ones we're going to take. So here's the red ones. These are our red skills that we are going to take. Ebbing Pain. So it's a two-hit skill. We got first hit damage, second hit damage, decrease enemy and caster physical defense by an amount for an amount of seconds. We're going to use this. This will be our fourth skill, and this is for PvE. This is the PvE build. Next up we have is Pin Down. This is another great one, character level 60. Next up we have is Monstrous Swipe. Again, this is going to be character level 70. Next up we have character level 75. You're going to be getting Crazed Pull. One hit, we do an amount of damage, and we absorb 20% of damage dealt pull on hit. So again, this is just good. Let's just show off this preview real quick so you can just see. This is a really good one. So as you can see, we're gonna be, it's important for farming. This is a very, very good skill for when you're doing your PvE, when you're going through and you're taking out mobs, just because look, you get that big pull. So we pull all the enemies into us, and then we can just start going ham on them. And then the last skill that we take is this character level 80. Again, you will need Savage Massacre at level 10. The PvP build is slightly different. In fact, there's only two changes for our PvP build. Instead of taking Monstrous Swipe for our PvP build, we will take that out, and we will be putting in Curse of Immortality. This will increase our max HP by an amount for an amount of time, and we become unstoppable, and we heal 30% of damage taken. This is so good for PvP battles. Placing is, we're going to take Pin Down out. And for our PvP build, we will be adding Crazed Howl. mostly because it's fear. It's a great ability with fear. Just getting that fear on the opponent is just so good. I mean, and it's so good for PvP when you have a bunch of people and they're all running around trying to protect stuff like the resource battle. They're trying to protect their resources from you guys stealing it. You have a berserker go in, you fear them. It's going to help out so much, and it's for an amount of times, especially for conquest and you're trying to capture the towers. Somebody's defending the tower. This is a great PvP skill, like a must. Try Crazed House, so good. For our enhanced passives, you're going to be thinking, oh, well, which one should we prioritize? And, you know, as you level up, some of these extra ones will unlock. My suggestions is HP increase heavily. As you can see, I got my HP to level 15, HP increase. I think you have to go HP increase, physical attack increase, and then you're going to want to go with like your physical defense. Like those are the three most important: your health, your attack, and your defense. All right, now we're going to go and take a look at the Soul Linkers. The Soul Linkers, based on the way the game is and the way the campaign is, there's some bosses that are super hard and you're going to kind of need one of every type. So for your three placements, you kind of need one attacker, one defender, and one support, you know, just if you're doing the bosses, because you're going to face a boss that's weak against attack, you're going to face a boss that's weak against defense. And like some of them bosses, I know some people know, but if you're new to the game, you might not know. Them bosses later in the game, they're super hard. I mean, they're ridiculously hard. So you kind of need one of every type to level up. For attackers, I like Paramon. Paramon is good. What we kind of lack as a berserker is we don't have like a ton of CC. So Paramon helps with that. Just his ultimate ability, getting that every second, that stun. You know, that stun every second for 5 seconds is good. So that helps out a tremendous amount. Obviously, if you could get like a legendary, legendaries are insane. But I like Paramon for heroic. And then the Hecka girl, she's pretty good for PvP. For defense, again, I will go with Kaint Drone. Very, very good. His ultimate, you know, is going to increase our attack and defense. And is like him with the berserker is insane, because it just increases your attack and defense. I mean, the berserker just runs in and just does so much damage. Kaint Drone, this dude is insane with the berserker. I mean, amazing. Like this guy, get him, he's amazing. For support, obviously, if you can get the best support character, otherwise if you can't, the Dead Eternal Flower, Titus, you know, I can never say her name. She's really, really good too. Mind control 3 enemies. Now, when it comes to outfits, there's a bunch of different outfits you can pick. I mean, there's some pretty cool ones. The Berserker's got some really nice looking outfits. Like this one looks badass. This one looks bad. Like there's a lot of different ones that look badass, right? What I would kind of suggest is take this completely a different way, and you might disagree with me and that's fine. But one thing that I've noticed is as a character, right? Like as a character, if you do physical damage, it's a lot easier for you to increase your physical defense. Whereas it's really hard to increase your defense for the opposite of what you are. So if you're a magical attacker, you'll notice that like a lot of your abilities, like when you go into like growth, like you'll get like physical defense increase, right? Like we don't have a passive to increase our magical defense at all. And it's vice versa. If you're a magical attacker, you don't like see like a physical defense increase. And I've noticed that like with my Templar too. So my Templar is weak for physical attack. So one just slight suggestion that I could give is, you know, since we're a berserker and we don't really have any magic protection, we don't have too much magical defense, you could go with magical evade, or you could go with like just straight up magical defense. I think that'll help you. The berserker is really good in team fights. I mean, paired with other players, the berserker is amazing. The berserker is an interesting character, and I know a lot of people don't really pick him. Berserker's got like, you know, low pick rate and people don't, you know, but the berserker can be pretty good. It's just one-on-one, he kind of lacks. That's the only thing. Like, straight up, he's not perfect. He works better in groups. The Berserker works better in groups. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and we are going to talk about the Archer next. I'll see y'all very soon with some more A3 Still Alive. Stay happy, stay safe. We got Christmas coming up. Man, we about to have like a foot of, we're getting a snowstorm tomorrow. We're getting a super bad snowstorm tomorrow. So we're going to get like, I don't know how much snow, like almost a foot of snow or something. It's going to be crazy here where I live. I'll be stuck inside making videos. I love y'all. Stay happy. Peace.